Hey, if you use melatonin to fall asleep, here are three things you need to know. I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman of ConsumerLab.com, and we've been testing melatonin supplements for over 15 years. First, some melatonin gummies are not well made. Our tests revealed that one gummy had nearly twice as much melatonin as listed. A study in Boston showed that almost one-third of melatonin gummies were way off, some having none, others having up to 3.5 times as much melatonin as listed. Now, we've also found that some melatonin gummies are fine, although I'm not a fan of melatonin as a gummy. Why? Because you need to take melatonin about 45 minutes before you go to sleep, and that's a terrible time to be chewing on something sticky that can have up to a teaspoonful of sugar. Second, some melatonin supplements are made to have too much melatonin. To help trigger sleep, you only need a small amount of melatonin, about a third of a milligram for kids and 1 milligram for adults. Taking 3 milligrams, for example, is more than enough for an adult. 5 milligrams, which is common, is more than you need in a gummy, but it can be okay in an extended release tablet, which is actually the way it's sold in Europe, where it is a prescription drug, but is only to be used for up to 12 weeks because the long-term consequences of taking melatonin is not known. Third, try plain melatonin. Many melatonin supplements now contain a variety of other ingredients and special formulas, and these have typically not been tested. Try just plain melatonin in a small tablet or capsule or liquid. You should be able to get it for as little as a nickel, while gummies often cost about 4 times as much. If you are one of more than 90,000 Consumer Lab members who support our research, you can go online right now and see our melatonin supplements review, which will show you how melatonin gummies and other melatonin supplements compare, and our top picks.